Welcome to Auto Technic. My name is Nick, and in today's video, we're going to be reassembling this Berkeley 12JG jet drive. This is not a video on a full rebuild because this jet drive was rebuilt and then I took it apart only to refinish it and paint it. So it's not 100% torn down. Items like the input shaft bearing, the wear ring and isolator, and the ball bushings and seals are still installed into the pump. I will talk about those a little bit, but mainly today's video is just going to be reassembling the pump. If you're interested on the process I took to get everything refinished and painted, please check out my other videos. That video is posted. So this housing here is bare with the exception of this inner suction seal and the wear ring and isolator. Now, one thing on this seal is it's actually purposely installed backwards. So this is the outer seal, and you can see it has the front side here and the back side with the spring. Now the way these seals are designed is they're designed to hold pressure pushing from this back side of the spring. So if this seal is installed this way with pressure pushing on the front side, it's very easy for anything to make it past the seal. Now, that's a little unusual because it's purposely installed backwards in this suction housing, and this front seal is installed essentially in the same direction. But the purpose of that is with the grease port, if we're greasing this and we over-grease it, it will purposely push the grease past the seal and not push the seals out. So it's kind of a little design safety measure that they built into this. Now, on our housing, like I said, this is a brand new wear ring. An isolator. I did not remove it. There's a lot of different methods to remove these. Some guys heat them up, some guys weld tools on them. Again, I took this apart only to paint it. There was no rebuilding that I'm doing to this. This was only just dismantled for ease of access and allow a cleaner paint job. Our two bowl bushings, bowl seal, those are all brand new. Again, the shaft was brand new, replaced during the rebuild because our old one was bent. The bearing's brand new. So we're not going to cover those items. We're going to just start with getting the shaft into the pump housing. Again, our inner seal is already installed in the what would be incorrect position, which is correct for this application. We're going to work on getting the shaft installed, getting the packing glands installed. Got the pump housing sitting up here on the bowl end. And I'm going to start just by sliding my shaft in. And just letting it sit right there on the table. And on this particular pump, I have five of these gland ring seals. So I'm gonna install these one at a time, and I'm gonna overlap the opening 180 out each time on the seals. And I can use the retaining plate to help drive them in. So I'm starting with the first seal in the up position. I'm gonna just slide that in. Push it down. Move on to the next seal with the opening in the down position. So this retaining plate goes on, and both of these pieces are symmetrical, but they're offset. So that way it'll go and lock it in nice and symmetrical. So I'll put this in, tighten it down with the bolts, and we'll be ready to move on to the next step. So I'm going to put a little bit of grease, help lubricate the shaft as it goes into the forward suction housing seal, or rear if your orientation to the boat, and we'll drive that in. Now I need to get the shaft driven all the way in to seat this bearing into the suction housing, so I'm just using a standard dead blow. now we got the shaft inside the suction housing. I need to get this front bearing plate in, and I have the seal out of that because I took the old one out so I could paint it, and the old seal ended up getting ruined, so I bought a new one. This seal, again, goes in with the spring facing the bearing, and I just have this seal installer, and when you're using one of those, you just want to make sure it fits the outside dam of the seal as close as possible. Use whatever you have to drive them in. This is the best, but if you don't have it, whatever works. So just set that in there. Get it. I put a light coating of just generic grease over this gasket, so that way if I need to pull it off, it makes it less likely to stick, and hopefully I can reuse it. So again, I'm putting just enough on there to have a real light film. I'll end up wiping most all of this off with a paper towel because I don't want just grease oozing everywhere. I'm just merely extremely, extremely light coating. Now on this bearing plate, I will want that Loctite in, but I'm going to seat it in with the four bolts, and then I'll remove those bolts and apply a Loctite individually after the fact. Just getting the bolts in to get it started, and I'm just using typical Loctite 242. Make sure that I don't have any problems out on the water. Sealant on this greaser for the suction bearing, and we'll get that screwed right in. There we go. So next is I need to get the hardware in for the access cover, since I removed that. And it just has these bolts at the eyelets that slide in, and they're retained with these dowels where you can see they're staked on the end, and they're driven in this direction. I had to drive them out from the backside out. So I'm just going to go ahead and get everything set up and drive them back in the reverse of how they were removed. These pins won't slide in very easily from the buildup of the primer and paint. So I'm just going to clean these holes out real quick with a drill bit and hopefully remove some of that buildup to ease the installation of it. Being careful not to take any of the aluminum housing with it. Just getting that buildup out. And we'll see if we can get these driven in now. There we go. Hole cover, just put the O-ring on, again a light coat of grease just to help everything seal up, and just go ahead and slide that in, and then I'll just flip these up and use the retaining bolts to hold it in. Thank you. Okay guys, I'm getting ready to install the impeller, and I have it installed in the boat, and I just lightly bolted it down. And I did this because I don't have the socket to hold the end of the shaft from rotating as I torque the impeller nut down. I went to go build one, and I realized it was just kind of fruitless when I could just gently set the pump in here. I have the output shaft of the engine hooked up to the pump, so I basically have the rotation force of the engine that will prevent me from having this rotate while I torque it down. I did build a socket for the nut for the pump, and I just bought the cheapest, 46 millimeter. It was the what fit best on the nut. And then I just bought another cheap socket from Harbor Freight and welded it on, ground out the inside so it slides over. All in all, I'm invested into that setup probably about $25 versus the $80 they sell for the special tool. So it's a good solution. Is what I plan on doing is I'm going to anti-seize the impeller, get that slid on, and then even though I have a lock nut for this impeller, I'm going to put more Loctite 242 on there. Yes, to help it keep the impeller on, but more so for corrosion. I don't want to put anti-seize on the nut. I don't want any corrosion in between that nut and the shaft, so I'm just going to use Loctite basically to prevent water from getting in there, and then I'm going to torque it down to 80 foot-pounds. So I'm going to go and just get the anti-seize, and I'm going to be liberal with it where the impeller sits on the shaft. I'm going to set the keyway in. I'm going to hit the top of that with some anti-seize. Go and slide the impeller on. So, and then get some of the Loctite on there. I'm going to put a little on the nut also. That spun on. Our socket on there. Get this thing torqued. Now that we got the impeller installed, I'm going to install the bowl. So I'm going to put just a real light coat of wheel bearing grease here on this shaft where it slides into the bushings and seal. Install our bowl gasket, which is the same as the other gaskets. I lightly covered it with a real thin layer of grease just so that way if I ever need to remove it, it won't stick. And hopefully I'll be able to reuse the gasket. That's something that you don't have to do, but just preference. And we'll get the bowl. We'll slide the bowl on, and you have to pay attention to the orientation of the ports for the oil. Be careful not to get that seal rolled up on it over the shaft. Slide the bowl on. Prop it up back here. So. Now we need to run it in with the bolts. And we're gonna be running those in and torquing them to 70 foot-pounds. And again, like everything else, Loctite 242. Slide that. Now, yes, the Loctite's there to prevent the bolts from backing out, but it's also there to prevent the corrosion. And I have dissimilar metals. I have a stainless steel bolt, an aluminum housing, and since this is a Berkeley bowl and we have the oil in the back here, which is filled into one of these fill ports. On the other side is also a fill port, both spaced evenly at the top. This is full of oil, so we have this end cap that we need to install, and we need to seal this with some silicone and then just screw it in. So let me cut open my tube of silicone here. And just put a light coat around that, so that way the oil doesn't leak out. Just like so. And we'll just spin this in. That. Snug her down. Not too tight, because this particular cap happens to be plastic. They do make aluminum ones you can buy to use instead, but plastic one will work just fine. Please like, subscribe, and comment if you have any questions on the video. I'd like to hear what you guys thought. Thanks for watching.